Hi students, you are watching Biology for All with Dr. Mahmoud Hassan. Today we will study the structure of plasma membrane. In all eukaryotic cells, the plasma membrane surrounds a cytoplasm filled with ribosomes and organelles. Organelles are structures that are themselves encased in membranes. Some organelles, for example nuclei, mitochondria, and chloroplasts, are even surrounded by a double membrane. All cellular membranes are composed of two layers of phospholipids embedded with proteins. All are selectively permeable or semi-permeable, allowing only certain substances to cross the membrane. The unique function of cellular membranes are due to their different phospholipids and protein compositions. Decades of research have revealed the function performed by plasma membrane. This video is particularly designed to explain the structure of plasma membrane. Our understanding of the structure of plasma membrane is based on the work of Gorter and Grendel, Davson and Danielli, J.D. Robertson, and Singer and Nicholson. Keep watching this video till end to understand the structure of plasma membrane, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Biology for All. The plasma membrane of mammalian red blood cells, erythrocytes, have been particularly useful as a model for studies of membrane structures. Mammalian red blood cells do not contain nuclei or internal membranes, so they represent a source from which pure plasma membranes can be easily isolated for biochemical analysis. Indeed, studies of red blood cell plasma membrane provided the first evidence that biological membranes consist of lipid bilayers. In 1925, two Dutch scientists, Gorter and Grendel, extracted the membrane lipids from a known number of red blood cells corresponding to a known surface area of plasma membranes. Gorter and Grendel predicted the bilayer membrane structure as early as 1925. They knew that red blood cells, erythrocytes, have no nucleus or other organelles and thus have only plasma membrane. They also knew that the major chemical component of these membranes were phospholipids. The space-filling molecular model in this slide shows the basic structure of phospholipids, highlighting their hydrophilic or polar heads and hydrophobic tails. Molecules with hydrophilic and hydrophobic domains are amphipathetic molecules. Gorter and Grendel had measured the surface area of red blood cells. They then did a blood count and then disrupted a known number of red blood cells. Then they measured the amount of phospholipids in the membrane extracts. From this, they calculated that there are enough lipid molecules per cell to wrap around each cell twice. From these observations, they predicted the phospholipid bilayer with fatty acids interacting within the bilayer. The trilamellar structure is consistent with the protein-coated hydrophilic surfaces of a phospholipid bilayer in Davson and Danielli's protein-lipid protein sandwich. Observing that all cellular membranes had this trilamellar structure, Robertson further proposed his unit membrane model. All membranes consist of a clear phospholipid bilayer coated with electron-dense proteins. The static view of trilamellar models of membrane structure implied by Davson and Danielli or Robertson model was replaced in 1972 by Singer and Nicholson's fluid mosaic model. The fluid mosaic model was first proposed by Singer and Nicholson in 1972 to explain the structure of plasma membrane. The model has evolved somewhat over time, but it still best accounts for the structure and function of plasma membranes as we now understand them. The fluid mosaic model describes the structure of plasma membrane as a mosaic of components including phospholipids, cholesterol, proteins, and carbohydrates that give the membrane a fluid character. Plasma membrane ranges from 5 to 10 nanometer in thickness. For comparison, human red blood cells visible via light microscopy are approximately 8 micrometer wide or approximately 1000 times wider than a plasma membrane. The proportion of proteins, lipids, and carbohydrates in the plasma membrane vary with cell types. For example, myelin contains 18% proteins and 76% lipids. The mitochondrial inner membrane contains 76% proteins and 24% lipids. The main fabric of membrane is composed of amphiphilic or dual living phospholipid molecules. The hydrophilic or water living areas of these molecules are in contact with the aqueous fluid both inside and outside the cell. Hydrophobic or water hating molecules tend to be nonpolar. A phospholipid molecule consists of a 3-carbon glycerol backbone with 2 fatty acid molecules attached to carbon 1 and 2 and a phosphate containing group attached to the 3rd carbon. This arrangement gives the overall molecule an area described as its head, the phosphate containing group, which has a polar character or negative charge, and an area called the tail, the fatty acids, which has no charge. They interact with other non-polar molecules in chemical reactions, but generally do not interact with the polar molecules. When placed in water, hydrophobic molecules tend to form a ball or a cluster. The hydrophilic region of phospholipids tend to form hydrogen bond with water and other polar molecules on both exterior and interior of the cell. Thus, the membrane surfaces that face the interior and exterior of the cell are hydrophilic. In contrast, the middle of the cell membrane is hydrophobic and will not interact with water. Therefore, phospholipids form an excellent lipid bilayer cell membrane that separates fluid within the cell from the fluids outside of the cell. Proteins make up the second major component of plasma membranes. Integral proteins are, as their name suggests, integrated completely into the membrane structure, and their hydrophobic membrane spanning regions interact with the hydrophobic region of the phospholipid bilayer. Single pass integral membrane proteins usually have a hydrophobic transmembrane segment that consists of 20 to 25 amino acids. Some span only part of the membrane, associating with a single layer, while others stretch from one side of the membrane to the other side and are exposed on either side. Carbohydrates are the third major component of plasma membrane. They are always found on the exterior surface of cells and are bound either to proteins forming glycoproteins or to the lipids forming glycolipids. These carbohydrate chains may consist of 2 to 60 monosaccharide units and can either be straight or branched. Along with the peripheral proteins, carbohydrates form special sites on the cell surface that allow cells to recognize each other. This recognition function is very important to cells as it allows the immune system to differentiate between body cells called self and foreign cells or tissue called non-self. Similar types of glycoproteins and glycolipids are found on the surface of viruses and may change frequently, preventing immune cells from recognizing and attacking them. These carbohydrates on the exterior surface of the cell, the carbohydrate component of both glycoproteins and glycolipids, are collectively referred to as the glycocalyx, meaning sugar coating. The glycocalyx is highly hydrophilic and attracts large amount of water to the surface of the cell. This aids in the interaction of cell with its watery environment and in the cell's ability to obtain substances dissolved in the water. So the main takeaway from this model are that the main fabric of the membrane is composed of amphiphilic or dual living phospholipid molecules. Integral proteins, the second major component of the plasma membranes, are integrated completely into the membrane with their hydrophobic membrane spanning regions interacting with the hydrophobic region of the phospholipid bilayer. Carbohydrates, the third major component of the plasma membrane, are always found on the exterior surface of the cells where they are bound either to proteins forming glycoproteins or to lipids forming glycolipids. This is all about the plasma membrane structure that you should know at this level. Please subscribe to my channel Biology for All and press icon to learn more about the cell and its organelles. Bye for now. See you soon.